हाई स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू ऑल फोर्स मैथ्स क्लास। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड फोर डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ इक्वेशन ऑफ स्ट्रेट लाइन्स। नाउ आई एम कमिंग टू फिफ्थ टाइप, दैट इज जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ ए स्ट्रेट लाइन, इक्वेशन ऑफ द स्ट्रेट लाइन इन जनरल फॉर्म। ओके, coming to the point, the first degree equation in x and y always represent a straight line. The first degree equation in x and y always represent a straight line. The general equation of the straight line is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, where abc belongs to real numbers and a square plus b square not equal to 0. Here every first degree equation represents a straight line. And at the same time, the general form or standard equation of the straight line is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Please observe this equation, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. The degree of this value, a into x, means the degree of x is 1, the degree of y is 1. It is the constant term, this degree is 0. Finally, the degree of this expression is 1. Okay, so finally the degree of this equation is 1. So it is the first degree equation in x and y. So it is said to be general equation or standard equation of the straight line. Here, what are the values of ABC? ABC are real numbers. Suppose the equation is in this type, x plus 2y plus 5. It is the standard form or general form of the straight line. Suppose the equation is in this way, 0 into x plus 2 into y plus 5 is equal to 0. It is also a standard form of, also the equation of the line. Suppose y coefficient is also 0, 0 into x plus 0 into y plus 5 is equal to 0. The degree of this value is 0 into x means 0. The degree is 1, this value is 0. Finally, the degree is 1. In this case, this degree is 0, this degree is 0, this degree is 0. It is the 0 degree equation. It is meaningless form. Okay. The first degree equation ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 represent a straight line when a square plus b square not equal to 0. What is the meaning of this value? Suppose a comma b are two real numbers such that a square plus b square is equal to 0. What is the condition? A is equal to 0 and b is equal to 0. Square of the sum of the squares of the two real numbers 0, each value must be 0. Here a square plus b square not equal to 0 means a is equal to 0 and b not equal to 0, or a not equal to 0 and b is equal to 0, or a not equal to 0, b not equal to 0. Okay, a square plus b square not equal to 0 means these three cases will arise in this value. Okay, suppose a 0, b 0, then it is not a straight line. In all the remaining cases, that equation is a standard form or general equation of the line. Okay, what is the standard form of the line? Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Okay, please note this value. General form of a straight line, fifth form. The first degree equation in x and y always represent a straight line. The general equation of the straight line is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, where abc belongs to R and a square plus b square not equal to 0. Okay, suppose this line passes through origin, what is the condition? Suppose the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 passes through the origin, what is the condition? It is the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Okay, this line passes through origin, that means 0, 0. The line passes through origin means by substituting a point in this line, that line satisfies. Okay, that means a into 0 plus b into 0 plus c is equal to 0. What is the meaning of this? 0 plus 0 plus c is equal to 0, that means c is equal to 0. If the line passes through origin, then the condition is c is equal to 0. Okay, please note this point, note first one. If the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 passes through origin, then what is the condition? C is equal to 0. If any first degree equation x and y constant term is 0, then that line must be passes through origin. Please note this value. Since the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 passes through, since the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 passes through 0, 0. Therefore, by substituting this point in this equation, a into 0 plus b into 0 plus c is equal to 0, that means c is equal to 0. Okay, next, second one, what is the slope of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0? What is the slope of the line? It is the standard form or general form of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. What is the slope of this line? Already we know about the slope point form. If the line is in the form of y is equal to mx plus c, what is this value? It is the slope of the line. Suppose we convert the general form into this slope point, slope intercept form, then we get the slope of the line. So ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That means what is the value of by? By is equal to minus ax minus c. Move this value b to RHS. That means y is equal to minus ax minus c by b. That is implies y is equal to minus a by b into x. Split this value into two parts. Plus minus c by b. Please observe this value. It is in the form of y is equal to mx plus c. What is the value of m? M is nothing but minus a by b. The slope of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is minus a by b. That means minus x coefficient by y coefficient. For getting the slope, the given equation can be reduced into slope intercept form. That means y is equal to mx plus form. By using that condition, we find the slope of this line. Okay, please note this value. Second point, the slope of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is minus a by b. That is equal to minus, what is the value of a? X coefficient by y coefficient. Minus of x coefficient by y coefficient. Okay, the slope of the line is minus a by b. Suppose this line is horizontal line, what is the condition? Suppose this is the line is in this way. What is the horizontal line? Horizontal lines are nothing but the lines which are parallel to x-axis. What is the slope of the horizontal line? Slope of the horizontal line is 0. If the two lines are parallel, then the two slopes are equal. M1 is equal to M2. Here, the slope of the line AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 is minus A by B. But it is parallel to x-axis or horizontal line. But it is horizontal line or parallel to x-axis. Then what is the slope? 0. Minus a by b is equal to 0. Then what is the condition? A is equal to 0. If x coefficient is equal to 0, then this line is parallel to x-axis or horizontal line. Suppose this line is vertical line. Vertical line means this way. Vertical line, what is the condition? If the line is vertical, what is the slope of the vertical line? Infinite, not defined. Slope is not defined. Here, what is the slope? Minus a by b. Infinite means denominator must be 0. It is not defined when b is equal to 0. If b is equal to 0, then the line is vertical line or parallel to y-axis. Okay? Please note this value. Third point. If the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is horizontal line, then what is the condition? A is equal to 0. That is, x coefficient is equal to 0. Since for the slope of the horizontal line is 0. But the slope of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is minus a by b. Therefore, minus a by b is equal to 0. This line is parallel to x-axis. What is the slope of the x-axis? 0. Therefore, minus a by b is equal to 0. If two lines are parallel, m1 is equal to m2. That means a is equal to 0. Okay. Next, fourth one. If the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is vertical line, then b is equal to 0. That is, coefficient of y is equal to 0. Since the slope of vertical line is not defined, that means something by 0, infinite. But here the slope is minus b by a. That means minus a by b. That means slope is minus a by b. Denominator must be 0. So b is equal to 0. Okay? Please note these four values. Next. Fifth point. What are the x and y intercepts of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0? What are the x and y intercepts of the line?
Suppose the line is ax plus by plus c is equal 0.
The line is ax plus by plus c is equal 0.
What is the intercept form of a line? X by a plus y by b is equal to 1.
Suppose the line is in the form of x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. Then this line cuts the x-axis at a comma 0. Y-axis at 0 comma b. Here a is said to be x-intercept and b is said to be y-intercept. So first we reduce the given equation into intercept form. By using that condition we find the x-intercept and y-intercept. So what is the given equation? Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Move this constant to RHS. That means ax plus by is equal to minus c.
Okay, by dividing on both sides with minus c, we get ax plus by by minus c is equal to minus c by minus c. Okay, that means ax by minus c plus by by minus c is equal to 1. Next, what is the meaning of this value? X by minus c by a plus y by minus c by b is equal to 1.
Please observe this value. It is in the form of the intercept form x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. What is the x-intercept of the line? Minus c by a. What is the y-intercept of the line? Minus c by b. Okay? X-intercept of the line is equal to minus c by a. Y-intercept of the line is equal to minus c by b. Okay? Please note this value. Next, sixth point. X-intercept of the line. X-intercept of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is minus c by a. X-intercept of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is minus c by a. Next, y-intercept of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is minus c by b. Write the proof also. Given line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That means ax plus by is equal to minus c. Dividing on both sides with minus c, we get this value. Finally, it is in the form of x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. Therefore, x-intercept of the line is equal to minus c by a and y-intercept of the line is equal to minus c by b. Okay. Next, suppose this line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 makes equal intercepts on the coordinate axis. What is the condition? The line, this line, suppose the line is in this way. The line makes equal intercepts on the coordinate axis. Makes equal intercepts means it is the x-intercept, it is the y-intercept. If this x-intercept is equal to y-intercept, what is the condition? Here, what are the x-intercept value? X-intercept and y-intercept value, x-intercept is equal to minus c by a and y-intercept is equal to minus c by b. Here minus minus cancel, cc cancel. That is, what is the meaning? A is equal to b. If the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 cuts the coordinate axis at equal intercepts, then x coefficient is equal to y coefficient. A is equal to b means x coefficient is equal to y coefficient. Okay, please note this value. Next, seventh value. If the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 makes equal intercepts on the coordinate axis, then a is equal to b, that is x coefficient is equal to y coefficient. Okay, next, please write the proof also. Here, what is the x coefficient? From the above proof, x coefficient is equal to minus c by a, y coefficient is equal to minus c by b. That implies a is equal to b. That implies x coefficient is equal to y coefficient. In any line, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, that line makes equal intercepts, then x coefficient must be equal to y coefficient. Okay? Next, eighth one. What is the area of the triangle formed by the line with coordinate axis? What is the equation of the line formed by the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 with coordinate axis? This is the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Area of the triangle formed by this line with coordinate axis means x-axis and y-axis. Here, what is the x-axis? It is x-axis, it is y-axis. Required area is this value. Okay. The line, given line is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. In this case, the given line is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. it can be reduced into intercept form. After reducing in intercept form, it can be converted into x by minus c by a plus y by minus c by b is equal to 1. Please observe this value. Already we proved this value. Intercept form of this value is x by minus c by a plus y by minus c by b is equal to 1. Here what is this value? This value is nothing but minus c by a. X intercept of the line a. What is this value? Minus c by b. Please observe these values. X intercept actually x by a plus, if the line is in the form of x by a plus y by b is equal to 1, a is the x intercept and b is the y intercept. Here x intercept is minus c by a, y intercept is minus c by b. Okay, if x intercept and y intercept are given, what is the area of this triangle OAB? Half mod AB. A means x intercept and B means y intercept. That means half into A means minus C by A into minus C by B. That is equal to C into C means C square by 2 mod AB. C square is always positive. AB is either positive or negative. So use mod AB. Okay, please note this value. Seventh one. The area of the triangle formed by the line AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 with coordinate axis is C square by 2 mod AB square units. Okay, proof. Given line is AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. Given line is AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. After converting into intercept form, it can be reduced into this way. X by minus C by A plus Y by minus C by B is equal to 1. Already we proved in the previous case. Okay. So, X intercept of that line is equal to, it is in the form of X by A plus Y by B is equal to 1. What is the X intercept? A is equal to minus C by A. Y intercept is equal to minus C by B. Please draw the diagram. Area of the triangle OAB is equal to half mod AB. If x intercept and y intercept are given, what is the area of the triangle with coordinate axis? Half mod AB. That is equal to half into, what is the value of A? Minus C by A into minus C by B. That is equal to C square by 2 mod AB. Okay. Next. Eighth point. Please observe this value. The given line is AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. If the line parallel to this and passing through the point PX1Y1, then what is that equation? The equation of the line which is parallel to AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 and passing through PX1Y1 is simply AX plus BY is equal to AX1 plus BY1. Please note this point first, eighth one. The equation of the line which is parallel to AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. The equation of the line which is parallel to AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 and passing through the point PX1 comma Y1 is AX plus BY is equal to AX1 plus BY1. What is the given equation of the line? AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. What is the slope of this line? Slope of this line is equal to minus A by B. But the required line is parallel to this line. If the two lines are parallel, what is the condition? Slopes are equal. Since two lines are parallel. So, slope of the required line is equal to minus A by B. Since two lines are parallel, the condition is slopes are equal. Okay, slope of this line is minus A by B and one of the point on the line is PX1Y1. If slope and point are given, what is the equation of the line? Y minus Y1 is equal to M into X minus X1. That means Y minus Y1 means Y1 is equal to minus A by B into X minus X1. After cross multiplication, it can be reduced into BY minus BY1 is equal to minus AX plus AX1. Okay, what is the meaning of this value? That implies AX plus BY is equal to AX1 plus BY1. Okay, please note this value. Already in slope point form, already we discussed about this value. If M is equal to minus A by B and point is X1, Y1, what is the equation of the line? AX plus BY is equal to AX1 plus BY1. Direct formula. In this case, same. Okay, please note this value. The slope of the line AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 is minus A by B. Since two lines are parallel, therefore slope of the required line is equal to minus A by B. If two lines are parallel, what is the condition? Slopes are equal. And the point is, since the line passes through the point P x1 y1, therefore equation of the required line y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Okay, that means by minus by1 is equal to minus ax plus ax1. So finally we get ax plus by is equal to ax1 plus by1. Please observe this point. The equation of the line which is parallel to this and passing through this point is ax plus by is equal to ax1 plus by1. Already we proved. Here ax, ax both are same. X coefficients are same. Y coefficients are also same. What is the difference? This constant changed. Okay, that means minus of ax1 plus by1 plus c is equal to 0. Suppose the given line is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Then what is the equation of the line which is parallel to ax plus by plus c is equal to 0? The line which is parallel to this value is nothing but simply ax plus by plus k is equal to 0. This value changes. A is constant, b is constant. If x1, y1 changes, this value automatically changes. So the equation of the line which is parallel to this line is ax plus by plus k is equal to 0. Please note next point. If next point, if sorry, the equation of the line which is parallel to ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Which is parallel to the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is in the form of ax plus by plus k is equal to 0, where k is constant. Next condition. In this case, we find the line which is parallel to the given line. Suppose what is the equation of the line perpendicular to this line? Okay. Please write this value. The equation of the line which is perpendicular to ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 and passing through the point px1 comma y1 is the equation of the line which is perpendicular to this line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 and passing through the point p x1 comma y1 is bx minus ay is equal to bx1 minus ay1. In this case also, what is the slope of this line? The given line slope is equal to the slope of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is minus a by b. It is the slope of the given line. But required line is perpendicular. That means, say this value is m1, the required slope be m2. Let m2 be the slope of the required line. Then what is the condition? M1 m2 is equal to minus 1. That means m1 into minus a by b is equal to minus 1. What is the slope of, sorry, minus a by b into m2 is equal to minus 1. The value of m2 is equal to, what is that value? B by A. So the slope of the required line is B by A. If the slope and point are given, what is the equation of the line? If slope and point are given, the equation of the line is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Okay, what is the slope of the given line, required line? B by A. Y minus y1 is equal to B by A into x minus x1. Okay, after cross multiplication, ay minus ay1 is equal to bx minus bx1. Okay, move this ay to RHS and bx1 to LHS. What is that value? Bx minus ay is equal to bx1 minus ay1. It is the equation of the line. Okay, please note this value. The equation of the line which is perpendicular to ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 and passing to the point px1 comma y1 is bx minus ay is equal to bx1 minus ay1. Okay. Next. Suppose it is a given line. What is the general equation of the line which is perpendicular to this value?
Already we proved the perpendicular equation is what is that value? Bx minus ay is equal to bx1 minus ay1. Please observe these values. X coefficient and y coefficient are interchanged. Please observe this value. And here it is a plus, we take minus, opposite sign. That means, and at the same time this constant changes. The equation of the line which is perpendicular to ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is in the form of bx minus ay plus k is equal to 0. Please observe this value. Here slope of the line is minus a by b. Here slope of the line is b by a. If m1, m2 is equal to minus 1, then the two lines are perpendicular. Okay, by using that property, we find this equation. Okay, please write this value. The equation of the line which is perpendicular to ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is in the form of bx minus ay plus k is equal to 0, where k is constant. Where k is constant. Okay. Next, sixth one. Perpendicular form or normal form of a straight line. Please note the statement. The equation of the line which is at a distance of p units from the origin. The equation of the line which is at a distance of p units from the origin and alpha is the angle made by the perpendicular with positive direction of x-axis is x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p. X cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p, where 0 less than or equal to alpha less than 360. 0 is closed, 360 is open, comma p greater than or equal to 0. Please observe the statement. Now we find the equation of the line which is at a distance of p units from the origin. Say this is one of the line. It is the origin. The distance from origin to the line is p units. Distance is nothing but perpendicular distance. So the perpendicular distance from origin to this value, say this value is the perpendicular value. Say this value is m be the projection of, let m be the projection of O on the line L. Okay, this length must be p units. It is a given at a distance of p units from the origin. Okay, next. And alpha is the angle made by the perpendicular with positive direction of x-axis. Alpha is the angle made by the positive x-axis and perpendicular in positive direction in this value. That means this angle is equal to alpha. Please observe this value, okay? It is the diagram. M be the projection of O on the line L. Next, let N be the projection of M. Let M be the projection of on x-axis. Let N be the projection of M on x-axis. Okay? Now, coming to the point. Okay, these values are understood. Okay, next, this angle is alpha, this perpendicular distance is P. Now, from the triangle OMN, here please observe this value, M is the projection of O on the line L and N is the projection of M on x-axis. Okay, from triangle OMN, what is the value of this value? OM is equal to P. This is 90 degrees. By using trigonometric values, what is the sine value? Sine alpha is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite signs means NM by P. Hypotenuse is nothing but NM by P. That implies, what is the value of NM? NM is equal to P sine alpha. Okay, next, cos alpha. What is the value of cos alpha? Cos alpha is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. That means ON by P. That means ON is equal to P cos alpha. Therefore, what are the coordinates of M? Coordinates of M are nothing but, this is the X coordinate value. It is the Y coordinate value. Okay, what is this value? ON is equal to P cos alpha. NM is equal to P sin alpha. So this coordinate is nothing but P cos alpha comma P sin alpha. Okay, now we find the value of M. Now required value is equation of the line L. Now we find the equation of this line. Please observe this value. Already the point M is P cos alpha comma P sin alpha. One of the point on the line is given. That means we find.
We find one other point on the line. Suppose slope is given, what is the equation of the line? Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Now we find the slope. How we find the slope? Here, slope of OM is nothing but two points. If two points are given, slope is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. If the slope OM is equal to, now the slope of the line OM, OM slope is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 means p sin alpha by y2 minus p sin alpha minus 0 by p cos alpha minus 0. P cos alpha. P, P cancel. That is equal to sin alpha by cos alpha. But OP is perpendicular to, but the line L is perpendicular to OM. Perpendicular to OM. Therefore, what is the slope of the line L? That implies slope of line L is equal to, here slope is A by B. What is the perpendicular slope? Minus B by A. M1, M2 is equal to minus 1. So this slope is minus cos alpha by sin alpha. If the slope is A by B, perpendicular slope must be minus B by A. Okay. By using that value, the slope of this line L is equal to minus cos alpha by sin alpha. Here slope M is given and point is given. What is the equation of the line? Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Therefore, equation of the line is, equation of line is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Okay, that means, that implies y minus y1 means, what is the value x1, y1 is this value. Y minus p sin alpha is equal to, what is the value of m? Minus cos alpha by sin alpha into x minus x1 means, what is the value of x1? P cos alpha. P cos alpha. After simplification, cross multiplication, we get y sin alpha minus p sin square alpha is equal to minus x cos alpha plus p cos square alpha. Okay. Move this value to LHS. That means x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to, move this value to RHS. P is the common term. P of cos square alpha plus sin square alpha. What is the value of cos square alpha plus sin square alpha? 1. So x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to P. It is the equation of the line. It is the equation of the line. Okay. Please note this value.